हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ मंजू शर्मा फ्रॉम सुरेश केएनवीआर यूनिवर्सिटी जगतपुरा चैपो, डिपार्टमेंट इज स्कूल ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर। द सब्जेक्ट इज ऑर्गेनिक प्रोडक्शन टेक्नोलॉजी एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सॉइल फर्टिलिटी इन ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग। सो फर्स्ट इज इंट्रोडक्शन। Soil fertility is defined as the ability of a soil to provide the conditions required for plant growth. It is a result of the physical, chemical, and biological processes that act together to provide nutrients, water, aeration, and stability to the plant, as well as freedom from any substances that may inhibit the growth. One of the fundamental principles of organic farming is to manage soil organic carbon to increase soil health, because the use of synthetic fertilizers is prohibited. Organic producers increase soil fertility by incorporating manure or compost into the soil, leading to increased soil organic carbon. Soil health is the foundation of organic farming system. Fertile soil, which provides essential nutrients to plants while supporting a diverse and active biotic community that helps the soil resist environmental degradation. The organic producers face unique challenges in managing soil productivity. Current guidelines on nutrient management for organic farmers are fairly general in nature. Organic farmers rely on intuition and observation, advice from vendors, conventional soil tests, and their own experience to make decisions about the quantity and types of soil amendments to apply. As a result, there is tremendous variability in both the quantities of nutrients applied and the resulting soil fertility status on organically managed farm. Here, organic farmers seek to build the soil or enhance its inherent fertility by using the crop rotations, animal and green manures, and cover crops, biofertilizers, vermicompost, etc. The crop production and tillage practices must provide an appropriate seedbed and pest control while minimizing erosion. So here, the organic farming, in which included green leaf manures, crop production, biological management, animal husbandry, biofertilizers, manure, and vermicompost. So these all are the different types of components of organic farming, which basically we use in organic production technology. Soil preparation. So in soil preparation, there are two types. First is cultivate the soil via your preferred method. So this provides a number of benefits for your plants, including drainage, proper root movement to obtain the necessary water and nutrients, and aeration. Properly aerated soil, which ensures the root obtain the oxygen needed to thrive. So basically, ensure the soil is not too dry if it is too dry, it will not only appear dry but also the brittle or hard to the touch. Water the ground well as written the next that you checked it again. Ensure the soil is not too wet. Obvious dry, it will only appear dry but also be brittle or hard to the touch. Water the ground well and return the next day to check it again. Ensure the soil is not too wet. Obvious signs include instance in which the ground is flooded is muddy. Remove the weeds and debris. Tilling under green matter will require waiting about a month until planting. Pay a local farmer to cultivate a large garden or use a rotary tiller to turn the soil. So here two types of soil is given. Add your choice of organic matter to your organic garden plot. While plants need sunshine and water to survive, they also need the vitamins and minerals provided by decomposing organisms to while plants need sunshine and water to survive, they also need the vitamins and minerals provided by decomposing organisms to thrive. Place a layer of organic compost over the entire area, approximately 1 to 3 inches, 2.5 to 7.6 centimeter of compost, then worked into the first of soil is one of the most commonly used method to prepare the organic soil. Request leaf mold from the town leaf dump is available. The leaves should be decomposed as fresh leaves will harm your organic garden. Ask a local farmer for manure. Most family farmers will gladly offer it for free, particularly if you do the work to obtain it. Use only aged manure or it may burn your plants. If only fresh manure is available, then compost it for a best 6 months below spray or before the applying. Raise your own organic matter by planting buckwheat, hairy vetch or rye. Either compost these or by planting buckwheat, hairy vetch or in or either compost these or turn them under waiting a month before planting. So here the organic residue, organic mulch like organic residue, grass clippings, leaves, hay, straw, shredded bark, straw, shredded bark, wool bark, animal manure, etc. Organic mulches are temporary decay over time, so they add organic matter in soil, increase water retention, so they increase water retention capacity, provide nutrients and suppress the weeds. Advantage of organic mulch. Organic mulch provides nutrients to soil and plants because it decomposes over time. They conserve water and also protect from weed growth and aid in stopping soil erosion. Organic mulch can greatly improve the appearance of your landscape. Types of manure. Manures are manures are the organic material derived from animals human and plants residue which contain plant nutrients in complex organic form. Manures can be grouped bulky organic manure, concentrated organic manures. Bulky organic manures which contain a small percentage of nutrients and they are applied in large quantity. Bulky organic manures are farmyard manure, sheep and goat manure, poultry manure and green manure or crop residues. So farmyard manure refers to the decomposed mixture of dung and urine of farm animals along with litter left over. The quantity of nutrients in manures varies with type of animal, feed composition, quality and quantity of bedding material, length of storage and storage conditions. A typical application of 25 hectare the quantity of nutrients in manure varies with type of animal, feed composition, quality and quantity of bedding material, length of storage a typical application of 25 ton hectare is one farm yard manure from housed organic cattle will contain 150 kg of nitrogen, 35 kg of potash, and 140 kg of potassium and phosphorus. Sheep and goat manure. Dropping of sheep and goats contain higher nutrients than farmyard manure, and compost and average the manures contain 3% nitrogen, 1% phosphorus, and 2% potassium. The third is the poultry manure. It ferments very quickly. 50% of its nitrogen, 50% of nitrogen is lost in 30 days. It contains 3.3% nitrogen, 2.63% phosphorus, and 1.2% potassium. After that, green manure. Green manure, many crops are grown and at vegetative stage milk up in the soil just to improve the organic matter. So many crops are grown and its vegetative stays mix up in the soil just to improve the organic matter. The soil at vegetative stays, these crops are easily decomposed in soil. And work like inorganic fertilizer due to having low carbon nitrogen ratio. Advantage of organic manures. Organic manure provide all the nutrients that are required by plants, but in limited quantities. It helps in maintaining carbon-nitrogen ratio in the soil and also increases the fertilizer and productivity of the soil. It improves the physical, chemical, and biological properties of the soil. Then it improves both the structure and texture of the soil. It increases the water holding capacity. So organic, what are the advantages of organic manures? Organic manure provide all the nutrients that are required by plants, but in limited quantities. It help in maintaining carbon nitrogen. Organic manure provides all the nutrients that are required by plants, but in organic manure, and it should be in limited quantities. It helps in maintaining carbon-nitrogen ratio in the soil and also increase the fertility and productivity. Of the soil, it improves the physical, chemical, and biological properties of the soil. Then it improves both. It improves both the structure and texture of the soil. It increases the water holding capacity of the soil. Then, due to increase in the biological activity by the nutrients and that are in the lower depth are made available to the plants. So it acts as mulch, thereby minimizing the evaporation losses. So due to increase the biological activity, the nutrients that are in the lower depth are made available to the plant. So the act as mulch, thereby minimizing the evaporation losses of moisture from the soil. Now, crop residue. Crop residue can be an important source of nutrients to subsequent crops. It is well documented. So, it is well documented that different quantities of nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium and minor nutrients are removed from and returned to the soil depending on the crop species concerned. So the quantity and quality of crop residue will clearly influence the buildup of soil organic matter. Then the next type is the concentrated organic manure. So they have high nutrient content that bulky organic manure. So they have higher nutrient contents than bulky organic manure. They have like oil cake and compost. Oil cakes. After oil is excreted from oil seed, the remaining solid portion is dried as oil cake within a Then the neem cake. Basically the oil cakes are two types, like neem cake or pungam cake. So first is the neem cake. Neem cake organic manure is the byproduct obtained in the process of core pressing of neem tree fruits and kernels, and the solvent excretion process for neem oil cake. Then pungam cake. Pungam oil cake organic manure is the byproduct obtained in the process of gold pressing of Pongamia karanji seeds. So action mechanism is like Pongamia cakes and action mechanism like Pongamia cake is an excellent biofertilizer and widely used in organic farming. Then compost. Mass of rotten organic matter which made from waste is called compost. It may be like farm compost. Composting is the natural process of rotting or decomposition of organic matter by microorganisms under controlled conditions. So the compost made from farm waste like sugarcane, thrash, paddy straw, weeds and other plants and under controlled condition, the compost made from farm waste like sugarcane thrash, paddy straw, wheat and other plants and other waste is called farm compost. Then the town compost. Then another type of compost is town compost. So the compost made from town refuse like night soil, street sweeping and dustbin refuse is called as town compost. Then nutrient management. Plant root system is always in close association with multitude microorganism and other nutrient. So the microbes in root zone are maintained due to a variety of secretion from the roots and constitute what is the microbes in root zone are maintained due to a variety of secretion from the starting. So the microbes in root zone are maintained due to a variety of secretion from the roots and constitute what is often described as rhizosphere. So these microbes in their turn supply nutrients to the soil system throughout their hydrophilic activity. Maintenance of these microbes in the rhizosphere. So maintenance of these microbes in rhizosphere therefore is also necessary for soil health. Then panchgavya. Panchgavya is an organic product having the panchgavya. Panchgavya is an organic product having the potential to play the role of promoting growth and providing immunity in plant system. Panchgavya consists of 9 products via cow dung, cow urine, milk, curd, jaggery, ghee, banana, and tender coconut and then water. So when suitably mixed and used, these have miraculous effects. Pseudomonas acetobacter and phosphorus bacteria etc. How long panchgavya stored? When strained twice daily, the panchgavya solution can be kept for 6 months without any deterioration in its quality. When the solution becomes thick due to evaporation of water over a long period, soluble quantity of water can be added to keep it in a liquid state. Protocol for panchgavya preparation. Like mix thoroughly fresh cow dung 7 kg plus cow ghee should be 1 kg. Incubate for 2 days. Then add cow urine 3 liter plus 10 liter of water. that still properly morning and evening daily for 1 week. Then we have to add the sugarcane juice. It should be 3 liter. Add cow milk 2 liter. Add cow curd 2 liter. And add coconut water, that is 3 liter. And add yeast 100 gram and 12 ripe banana. So here the constituents of panchgavya: a cow milk, cow curd, cow urine, cow dung and cow ghee. Now the whole mixture to be incubate for 2 weeks, and the preparation should be filtered through double layer muslin cloth and stored in bottle under refrigerator and used as a when required. Then the doses of panchgavya recommended for field application, like spray system, 3% solution is effective. 3 liters of panchgavya mixed with every 100 liter of water is suitable for all crops. Then flow system: the solution of panchgavya can be mixed with the irrigation water at 48 to 52 liter per hectare, either through drip irrigation or flow irrigation. The whole mixture is to be incubated for 2 weeks, and the preparation should be filtered through double layered muslin cloth and stored in a bottle under refrigerator and used as when they require. Doses of panchgavya recommended for field application, like spray system, 3% solution is effective. 3 liters of panchgavya mixed with every 100 liter of water is suitable for all crop. Then the flow system: so the solution of panchgavya can be mixed with irrigation water at 48 to 52 liter per hectare, either through drip irrigation or flow irrigation. Now, effect of panchgavya on soil fertility. Panchgavya improve fertility status in soil by increasing macronutrients, micronutrients and beneficial microorganisms, thus increase the soil health. It improves water holding capacity of soil, thus increase the soil health. Water holding capacity of soil because it acts as an organic manure. It increases growth and reproduction of beneficial soil microorganism, and then it increases nutrients uptake in plant and enhance the plant growth. Then biofertilizers. Biofertilizer are substances that contain microorganisms which, when added to the soil, increase its fertility and also promote the plant growth. It comprises living organisms which include mycorrhizal fungi, blue-green algae and bacteria. Mycorrhizal fungi preferential withdraw mineral from organic matter for the plant, whereas cyanobacteria then it comprise living organism which include mycorrhizal fungi, blue green algae and bacteria. Mycorrhizal fungi presently withdraw mineral from organic matter for the plant, whereas cyanobacterium or cyanobacteria are characterized by the property of nutrient assess the role of biofertilizer for the improvement of soil fertility. Then bacteria, which works under two conditions like symbiotic or nitrogen fixation. Then the rhizobium Azospirillum species, pre-living nitrogen fixers, Acetobacter biobacteria, so that is the Acetobacter and Klebsiella. Then alga biofertilizer, BGA in association with Azolla and Azolla anabina, nostoc or oscillatoria. Third one is phosphate solubilizing bacteria like Pseudomonas, Bacillus, Megatherium. Fourth one is fungal biofertilizer, that is worm. So the rhizobium lives in the root hair of the legume by forming nodules. Plant roots supply invested minerals and newly synthesized substances to the bacteria. Azospirillum, it mainly present in cereal plant habitats. It mainly present in cereals, plant in habitats, both root cells as well as south. Then Acetobacter is a heterophilic or heterotrophic free living nitrogen fixing bacteria which present in alkaline and neutral soil. Apart from its ability to fix atmospheric nitrogen in same component, Azolla as a biofertilizer. Azolla is a tinny fresh water from common imports. Azolla is a biofertilizer, is a tinny fresh water fern common in ponds, ditches and drainage field. The nitrogen fixing work is vesicular arbuscular mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza is a mutualistic association between fungal mycelia and plant roots. Worm is an endotrophic, live inside and mycorrhizal formed biosubtid phycomycetes. And then worm help in nutrients transfer many of phosphorus and zinc and sulfur incrustation. These are the biofertilizers. drainage system. A key practice for improving soil drainage is incorporating organic matter like compost of posterior Organic manure improve then soil drainage is incorporating organic matter like drainage Drainage is intercropping organic matter like compost or well-rotted manure. Organic matter improves the increasing soil irrigation, which allows for more and varied pore size. Soil aggregates are grown. Soil aggregates as group of mineral particles that bind together. Basically, that is the diagram. Continuous macropores may cause the rapid movement. A key practice for improving soil drainage is incorporating organic matter like compost or well-rotted manure. Which matter improves soil structure by increasing soil aggregation, which allows for more and varied pore size. Soil aggregate. Soil aggregate are groups of mineral particles that bind together, aggregate stability, and. That bind together aggregate stability is the ability of soil aggregates to avoid disruption such as by water soil with high organic matter content have greater aggregate stability when incorporating organic matter the general rules of thumb for In general rule of thumb for compost is to spread a 2 to 3 inch layer over soil and work it in about 6 inches deep with spreading or tillage. Avoid cover tilling, especially with the roti. Using a rototiller too much or it's too open breaks down soil aggregate. And the other way to increase the organic.